Hello, good morning. This is Rick Pina, and I am bringing you today's word for January 28, 2014. The title of the message is Renewing Your Mind, Part 5. So obviously, I'm flowing in the same vein that I have been for quite some days, but it's about renewing your mind in order to embrace the grace of God. So it's this series that we've been teaching on now for 17 months, Grace That Is Simply Amazing. And like I said, for the last few messages, we've just been focusing on renewing your mind, because if you can renew your mind, then you'll be able to embrace and accept and then experience the grace of God. So yesterday, I talked to you about the story of Peter walking on water. Let's continue with that story. Let me go back to it real quick. So Jesus came to his disciples about 3 a.m. He had already fed the 5,000. He sent the people away. He sent his disciples on a boat to go to the other side of the lake. He spent some time with the Father in prayer. He comes to them. They're in the middle of a storm. The wind was beating against the ship. The waves were beating against the ship. The disciples were tired. And when Jesus came walking on the water, Jesus was walking on what they were afraid of, right? And as he came walking on the water, they thought he was a ghost and they were afraid. So Jesus said, it is I. Do not be afraid. And then when Peter heard, now all 12 disciples heard Jesus's voice, but Peter was the only one that heard this. Peter was the only one that was activated to do something. So Peter said, when he heard the voice of Jesus, and they're still not sure if that was Jesus or not, Peter said, Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water. If it's really you, I want you to authorize me to do what you're doing. If it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water. And Jesus replied, simple reply, he said, come. He said, yes. Basically, he was saying, you're authorized. You can do it. You come. Finally, I have one of the disciples that are ready to do what I'm doing, that are ready to operate on the level that I'm operating. Is this the supernatural? Yes, it is. He was defying the law of gravity. He's standing on water. He's standing on something he's not supposed to be standing on. And Jesus welcomes Peter to do it. It wasn't like Jesus said, no, Peter, you can't do it because I'm the only one who could do it because I'm the Son of God. No, he welcomed Peter to do it. Matter of fact, he didn't get upset with Peter, get excited with Peter. He said, come. Peter crawled down. He got, off the side of the boat, got down into the water. And Peter actually did it for a few steps anyway. He was walking on water. He was performing the supernatural. He did. He was living like Jesus lived. He was walking like Jesus walked. And then the Bible says that when he shifted his focus, when he started looking at the wind and the waves, then he lost it. He shifted his focus away from Jesus and the supernatural. He started to factor in the natural, and then he started to sink. He said, Jesus, save me. Jesus saved them. But then this is what Jesus said. Jesus did not say, man, Peter, good job. Hey, buddy, you're going to go down as the second man in history ever to walk on water. He didn't say, hey, man, hey, buddy, good job. I appreciate the fact that you operated in the supernatural. Finally, I got one of my disciples doing it. No, he said, Peter, you of little faith, why did you doubt me? He said, you of little faith. He called what Peter did little, and we'll talk about that today. So what does this mean to you today? It means I'm gonna share four things. Number one, you got to give yourself a license to dream. When you renew your mind, when you stop thinking the way that you used to be thinking, and you take the limits off of a limitless God, you renew your mind, you give yourself a license to dream God-sized dreams. Peter was the only disciple to get out of the boat. He was the only one to think that big. He was the only one to attempt to do what Jesus was doing. And as he was attempting it, he was giving himself a license to dream. Now, when you renew your mind, you will position yourself for God to give you dreams, and you will accept the dreams. You will almost like authorize yourself to be the man, the woman that God has called and destined and desires for you to be. When you renew your mind, you open yourself up to divine vision. You open yourself up for God to show you things. And if you can see it, see, you'll never be it until you see it. If you can see it, now you position yourself to be it. Number two, you got to muster up the courage to take your dream public. Now, it was one thing. Maybe one of the other disciples dreamed it too. Maybe one of the other disciples saw themselves walking on water. Maybe one of the other disciples thought about getting out the boat, but Peter was the only one to take it public. You got to muster up the courage to take God or take your dream public. I've heard it said that nothing happens until you announce it. I mean, when you announce it, you declare it, you take this thing public. Peter said, Lord Jesus, if that's you, then ask me to come. Authorize me to come to you walking on the water. And he said, come. He was the only one that vocalized it. And you have to muster up the courage to take God public and to say it. It's one thing to see it, but it's another thing to say it. It's one thing to see it. It's another thing to declare it, to declare it in faith. And he mustered up the courage to say it. And you and I, when we renew our mind, the renewed mind musters up the courage to say it, to take God public, to announce it, to say it before it happens. Anybody can say it after it happens. Hey man, God has been dealing with me on that. You see, now that it finally came to pass, let me tell everybody about it. No, you can speak faith-filled words even before it happens. You have to muster up the courage to take your dream public. Take your dream public today, this week, this year. Don't be afraid. Take your dream public. Tell people what you're dreaming about. Tell people the dreams that God has been giving you. So now you're putting pressure on God and pressure on yourself to step out there on those dreams. Number three, stop counting on your power alone. Stop counting on your power alone. Now listen, if Peter was going to walk on water, it was going to take God's power. Obviously, he could not walk on water with his own power. You and I can't do the supernatural with our own power. So it's going to take God's power. Well, if Jesus was walking on water, he was walking on water because the Father gave him the power to do it. Well, just like the Father gave Jesus the power to do it, the Father would give Peter the power to do it. And he did. Peter tapped into the supernatural and he walked on water. And it's not was hit with his power. It was with God's power. So take the limits off. The same power that the Father released on Jesus, he releases on us. As Jesus is, so are we in this world. We're supposed to walk with that power. So stop just counting on yourself. Count on God. When he gives you God-sized dreams, count on him to do it. Take them public and then pursue it by faith. And then lastly, prepare yourself to live in the supernatural. Prepare yourself not to dibble and dabble in the supernatural, but to live in the supernatural on a daily basis, on a permanent basis, to flow in the supernatural every day of your life. Where do you get that from, Rick? Well, remember, I told you I was going to come back to this. Jesus said, ye of little faith, why did you doubt? Now, the word little here about, he called Peter's faith little. Now, obviously, it wasn't little in quality. It wasn't little in quantity, because he did the supernatural. He only did it for a few steps, but he did walk on water, right? So it wasn't little like that. How was it little? It was little in duration. Basically, what Jesus was saying is, Peter, I'm not happy with the fact that you just had a short burst of faith. I'm happy that you operated in the supernatural and you finally tapped in, but I'm not happy that you only did it for a few seconds. So Jesus was not even satisfied with the fact that Peter tapped into the supernatural for a few seconds. He wanted him to live in the supernatural. He wants you and I to live in the supernatural by God's grace, not just to just tap in to the supernatural, you know, here and there, one day out of the week, or one day out of the month, or every now and again. Again, he wants us to live in the supernatural on a daily basis. So let's close this out with a confession. I'm going to lead you in this confession. You repeat after me and repeat it in faith. Say, Father, the more I study your grace, the more I realize that your supernatural power has been made freely available to me. My mind is being renewed to the point where I am open for whatever you want to do in my life. I ask you to help me take the limits off. I dream big dreams, divine dreams that are birthed from my relationship with you. I'm not afraid of dreaming. I'm not afraid of seeing myself the way you see me. My heart is open to receive all that you want to do through me. My mind is renewed to accept and to embrace your divine assignment for my life. You bless me to see it with my mind's eye in the spirit, and I muster up the courage to say it and to take you public even before it happens in the natural. I'm not afraid of crossing the faith line, of getting out there so far that it will not happen until you do it. I'm not afraid because I won't have to do it with my own power. As a matter of fact, I can never do it with my power. You are calling me to live beyond my limits, to live beyond my power, to live beyond humanity. You are calling me to operate in divinity. My heart says yes. My mouth says yes. My legs say yes. And by faith, I pursue your plans for my life. As I pursue it, it's not going to be short-lived. Peter walked on water for a few seconds, but I shall live in the supernatural for the rest of my life. I declare this by faith. In Jesus' name, amen. This is today's word. Apply it and prosper. Have a blessed day. God bless you.